I am going to review the IS 456-2000. This is the front page of the IS 456-2000. So name of the code is that Indian Standard Plain and Reinforced Concrete Code of Practice 4th Revision. And it is reprinted on 2007. So here in this code, if you see the code, there will be total 5 sections. The content will 5, you will get total 5 sections. Section 1 is general, section 2 material, workmanship, inspection, testing of concrete. Okay, not that structural testing. Section 3 is basically general design consideration. Section 4 is a special design requirement for structural member of the system. So here special design requirement. So here you'll see the rib section, hollow section, voided slab, deep beam, all those things are there. Flat slab. Okay, this is basically this is advanced course. If you want to have advanced course on reinforced concrete design, in that time section 4 will be much useful for you. Section 5 is the structural design limited method. So here you will get the most of the information related to the limited method. Different partial safety factor, design value. Okay, partial safety factor. What are that limited method, collapse and serviceability, compression member for the shear, torsion, cracking. Most of the information will be in the section 5. Structural design using limited method, and we will get many information on the section 3. Okay, so let me go to the section 1. So section 1, here you see that is basically for the symbols. What happened if we go inside the code, we will get a lot of equation is there. Some cases the symbol of the equations they explain near that equation, but sometimes you will find that is missing. In that case, you have to come to this page number 11 and you have to see what the symbol means, what is the significance of the symbol. Okay, in the section 1, only symbol is important for design purpose. The section 2 basically dealing with the material, workmanship, inspection, the testing. Basic this saying. Those are the basically you can say site engineer for that, for them section 2 is important, very much important, because in the material, what the suitable material is, okay, because design people are not bothered about the what material available, okay, what type of cement, what type of water, what type of aggregate is available, that they will directly specify that grade of concrete. Now how to achieve the grade of concrete is depend upon the site engineer. So basically section 2 is mainly for the site engineers, so those are working in the site, but for the reinforced concrete design purpose you should know, for exam purpose also it is very important. So there you will find many properties are there which is very important. As a student, all you also should know. So first we'll go through the each topic in the section 2-5 basically. Section 5 here you can say that clause 5 dealing with the material, cement, admixture, aggregate, water. Clause 6 is saying about the grade properties of the concrete. So basically it is talking about the grade of concrete and properties of concrete, the plain concrete, okay, not about the reinforced concrete. Workability of concrete, durability of concrete, concrete mix design, mix proportion. So it is mentioned here. But if you want to know more details about the concrete mix design, you should go to the code IS 10262. That is basically dedicatedly for the concrete mix design. But here you will get some sort of guideline for the mix design. And section here in the 10, you will get the production of concrete, quality, batching and mixing. Okay, while making concrete, what are the quality you should consider that they have formwork. If you want to place the concrete, you need to have formwork. And what are the different formwork there? What should be the setting time? When you can remove the formwork? All the things are specified here. All the things are specified here. Here in the 12, assembly of reinforcement, transportation, placing, compaction, and curing. So here, this part also for the site work. How to transport the concrete, how to place the concrete, how to compact, and how to cure. See, design people are not bothering how we are doing all the things. Okay, once they write that this grade of concrete should be there, that they are assuming the site engineer will be capable to achieve that grade. And here clause 14, concrete under special conditions. So if you have some unavoidable circumstances and special condition is there, in that case these are the some IS code specified some specific IS code is guided provided IS code provided some guidelines for the special circumstances. Here 15 is sampling strain of design concrete mix. It is saying that how we should test it, what should the frequency to sample, test sample result, and next is the acceptance criteria, inspection, and the testing. So basically section 2 dealing with the material and their suitability of the material for concrete construction and mixing, batching, what the quality should be there. All the things are mentioned in the section 2. Basically now you can judge that basically section 1 and the section 2 don't have much direct relation with the mixed design. But this, there you will find there are some property which is mentioned there is very important. After section 5, you will get many annexure. Okay, this is the additional part of the code. Here you can see that annexure B is talking about it, working stress method. Okay. So if you want to know what is the difference between limit state method and working stress method, section 5 is talking about limit state method. So here in the section 5, you can get what are the different assumptions, limit state of the collapse, list of the state of the serviceability. But if you want to know about the working stress method, then you have to come to the annexure B. The annexure B is basically based on the working stress method. But the permissible stress, the load in the compression member, member subject to axial load, all the things are there. Okay, but all are under working stress conditions. Now annexure C is talking about the calculation of the deflection. Short term deflection, deflection due to sinkage, deflection due to creep, all the things are mentioned here. So annex D is talking about the two-way slab spanning, slab spanning in the two direction. Okay. There are two category, one is the restrained slab and simply supported slab. After annex E, talking about effective length of the column. The length of the column basically depend upon the support conditions. If you have different kind of support, suppose one end is fixed, other is free, you can deliver thing, then effective length will be one thing. But if the two end are restrained, if two end are fixed or embedded, you can say in that case effective length will be different. So depending on the support conditions, effective length of the column is to be different. So if you come to the next E, you can find the different effective length. Annexure F is talking about the calculation of crack width, and annexure G, the moment of resistance for rectangular and T-section. So it is saying that how much moment it can resist, you can get it in the section G. So in the annexure G, annexure 8 is comity compositions, is not related to you. So up to annexure B, next up to annex H, up to annex G is important for you, from annex B to annex G. So annex B is basically for working stress method, annex C for deflection, annex D for two-way slab, Some information you get regarding the 2 slab. Next, E, effective length of the column, crack width, and G is talking about the restraint, moment of resistance. Okay, so up to G, and next G is important to you. In the section 1, very important part is the symbols. Okay, for design engineer or for the student, in the section 1, you will get only important information is about the symbol. Section 2 is talking about your material and that testing. Okay, it's not about the structural testing, it is talking about testing of the concrete. So there you will get that what through the quality of the ingredient, material, ingredient in the sense the cement and aggregate, water, what should be the quality of it, what should be the quality of the water, what should be the quality of aggregate, what should be the quality of sand, what should be the quality of cement. The basic information you can get in the section 2. And there also you will get that how to mix, mixing, batching, placing, compacting, formwork, all the details you will get in the section 2. Section 3 basically give you the general design guidelines. Section 3 is talking about design guidelines. So for those who are site engineer, for them section 2 is very important, and those are want to go for design, for them section 3 is very important. But for the as a student, you should know properly about that important part of the section 2 and important part of the section 3, section 4. Okay, so here the section 2 is talking about your material and the testing of concrete, not the structural testing. Section 3 is a design guidelines, right? General design considerations. Here you will get some philosophical things about your durability, your design process, dead load, live load, earthquake load, stability, fire resistance, all the things you will get in the section 3. You just see that solid slab beam here, the section, then the section 3, clause number 23, the beam, clause number 23, beam, clause number 24, solid slab, 25, compression member. 26 is talking about reinforcement and the detailing. You will find most of the information is from this here, 23. From 23 to 23, 24, 25, 26. Most information will be from here. Section 4 is basically for the special design requirement. So if you want to have an advanced course, in that case, it will be useful for you. Section 5 is limit state method. Okay, you will get some information. So here in the section 3, clause number 23 to clause number 23 to 26 will be important, and then we will get most useful information from section 5, limit state method. Once you finish this part, you will get more useful information regarding the design in the annexure C, annexure D, so E, F, and G. Okay, so this is the total overview on the IS 456-2000 code. Next we will try to see how IS code for concrete design has evolved. So here you can see this is the fourth revision. So it is saying that we put to that there is three revisions. So we'll try to see how the fourth revisions is developed. Or you can say coming to our consideration for design purpose for reinforced concrete design. You will find that IS code was first published in 1953, and the title of the code was Code of Practice for Plain and Reinforced Concrete for General Building Construction. And then first revision was done on 1957. Thereafter, the second revision was done on 1964. So what I think, 1953 and 1957, during this time this code was based on working stress method. In 1964, ultimate load method was developed. So IS code also revised as per ultimate load method. So 1957 was first revision, 1964 was second revision. And third revision was done on 1978. that is basically include limit state approach. So the fourth revision was done on the 2000. So this code basically the fourth revised version. The name of the code is that Indian Standard Plain and Reinforced Concrete Code of Practice. So this is the overview of your history, chronological history of Indian Standard for Reinforced Concrete Design. Initially in 1953-1957, it was based on working stress method. 1964, it was based on ultimate load method, and 1978, the third revision. And 2000, we have the fourth revision. So that's 2000 version, basically fourth revision version we are using for our design purpose. Here we'll try to see what are the changes has been made on the IS 456 2000 version. So here you can see in the first page itself, in the revision, there is some important changes as there. Important changes in the terms of durability. Earlier, durability was not considered properly, but in the 2000 version, durability has been included. And another major changes is there based on the sampling acceptance criteria for the concrete. This saying that this revised version is in line with the provision of BIS 5328 part 4 1990. Probably there is some discrepancy between these two codes. So what it is saying that part 4 specification will be considered for sampling, testing and assessing compliance of the concrete. Now it is saying that so these are the some important changes, and it is saying that in the defense section, IS code also made some significant changes. Section 2, it is saying that all the three grade of ordinary, Portland, cement. It is saying that in important changes, it is saying that all the three grade of ordinary Portland cement, namely 33, 43, 53, sulfate resisting Portland cement is included. So basically, it is broad up the range for the different cement. So we'll go details that what are the changes they have made. We'll see what are the different type of concrete IS 456 2000 version is allowed. Then they have changed some permissible limit. Permissible limit for solid in water. Basically, if you are using the water, then what should be the quality of water? Then there are some permissible limit they have changed. They also included the admixtures, and they will too. They have specified the grade of concrete. Earlier, our grade was up to 40 MPa. So, in 40 grade of concrete, it was allowed. But since that there is admixtures was developed, and there's high demand of high strength concrete, so IS 456 2000 version is allowing some higher grade of concrete. Now one more specification they've changed. It is saying that minimum grade of concrete shall not be less than M20. So it is saying that minimum 20 should be used. Earlier M15 was allowed, but they have abolish that. So minimum grade of concrete should be M20. So these are the things they have changed. And durability, just now I discussed, they have considering the durability in more serious way. They are introducing two more term, that is basically extreme exposure condition and very severe conditions. These two more conditions they have included. So here you will see what are the changes IS 456 2000 version have made. In the section 3, they want to introduce fire resistance. They also recommendations. They have recommendation for the effective length is also included. and recommendation regarding the deflection due to lateral load also added. So these are the changes they have done. So this is in the section 3. Similarly, you can see what are the changes they have done in the section 4. So these are the things are there, changes are there in the IS-456-2000 version. So now we'll try to go section wise and we'll see what are the things are there.